It was one of our most shared stories of the last year, a retiring rural veterinarian giving away his entire practice to someone willing to take it over. Tonight, Boyd Hooper introduces us to the young vet who traveled cross country to answer that call.
First stop, yeah.
When we last checked in on Dr. Robert Bogan, he was driving the vastness that is Faribault County.
I'm it, yeah.
The county's only veterinarian had recently upped the ante in a frustrating 5-year search for his replacement.
She's pregnant.
Dr. Bogan, at 74, had become painfully aware of a nationwide shortage of rural vets.
My lungs sound okay, huh?
In response, he'd announced he'd give away his clinic to a vet willing to move to Blue Earth.
Furniture?
Yes.
Practice?
Yep.
The building?
Yes.
His pickup truck and even Annie the office cat, free for the taking.
That's amazing.
And if Bill Rosenow and other farmers were stunned by the offer.
There's got to be somebody out there that's interested.
They were doubly surprised when our story about Dr. Bogan's offer was shared more than 8,000 times on Facebook.
This story spread far and wide. The message got to where it needed to go.
In September, 8 prospective vets rolled into Blue Earth to meet Dr. Bogan and tour the town. Among them, a new graduate of the Iowa State University Vet School.
I was just sitting in my apartment, scrolling through Facebook. I was like, that sounds like something I could do.
With his dog, Barkley, Zach Adams drove 17 hours from his vet residency in North Carolina to meet with Dr. Bogan.
That's a lot of driving.
Who was taken by Zach's determination. A young man who grew up with animals on a hobby farm outside an Iowa town of 900 people.
I was really happy when he said yes.
Something inside me was just like, yeah, this feels like where you're meant to be.
Plus,
I'm a diehard Vikings fan, so I've always wanted to live in Minnesota.
Just last month, Dr. Bogan began introducing Dr. Adams to his farmers.
This is Zach Adams.
The transition will take place over the next year or so, as Dr. Bogan shares his experience.
This knee is really big for some reason.
With the man.
It would be a sign of an injury.
Will take his place after 49 years.
Checking to see if the knee is in the socket like it's supposed to be.
Finally ensuring Faribault County won't be left without a vet.
To get somebody to come out and do on-site work would have been almost impossible because they would have been over an hour away.
We're just excited. The community's excited. I think most people know what house he bought.
Oh, yeah, you seem to like it. Yeah, good job.
Changes are coming. High on Zach's list, computerizing the clinic's record keeping.
She has a personality, I guess.
But Annie will stay put.
I had a lawyer take a look at my contract. He called me, he's like, you know you're getting a cat with this, right? I'm like, yeah, I did see that.
It's a big relief.
For one vet, a sunset. For the other, a sunrise.
Everything happens for a reason.
Same truck, soon, a new driver.
Here I am, and hopefully we can keep things rolling here in Blue Earth.
Boyd Hooper, Carol Evan News, Faribault County.
Well, if you saw the original story about Dr. Bogan, you may remember Leighton Becker, a second-year U of M vet student interning at the clinic. Initially, Leighton, too, was interested in taking over the practice, but he recently told Boyd it was just too early in his schooling to commit. Leighton said he met Dr. Adams when he visited Blue Earth and is happy for him. Mm.